I might be complicating these, but stick with me for a while. Turning between centers has always been a problem for me, mostly because I can't trust my spindle staper and I have to rely on a soft center held in the chuck. That has to be recut every time I use it, of course to be in line with the spindle axis, but that's not the real issue. The issue has always been driving the part. In the past, I have resorted to improvised solutions to drive one of my lathe dogs, but those were never really flexible or reusable. And today I have this to turn between centers, and I can't use a lathe dog. So although I'm improvising again, I'm going to fix this problem for good. Like I said, this tool is a side project of another one, a bigger one. We'll get to that on the next video. Right now, there's no drawing for this, or a proper plan. I just know what I need, I'm visualizing the result, and going for it. And aluminum? Yeah, that was my only option for this part. All the steel I have at the moment is either too small or way bigger than I need, just not worth turning down to size. But the thing is, I can't mess this one up, because it's the last bit of aluminum I have. As for the main body, I think I'll go with steel. This will be the part that gets clamped in the chuck, so it has to be steel. And this looks like the perfect size. I don't want to be changing chucks in the future, just to use this tool, so I'm making sure it fits a 5C collet. That's 30mm. My idea for this tool is to have a replaceable soft center. Something I can recut over and over again, basically every time I use it, without worrying if the center is getting short. Think of it like a consumable, and I'll try to make the hole for that in one go. That is, drilling from this end deep enough to reach the other end. So I'll start with the drill and then use a boring bar to straighten the hole. A 10mm reamer should finish it off nicely, and that way, my consumable should be very easy to get. I just made this from a piece of scrap. I know it's sketchy, but I think it's going to work. I didn't want to waste too much time on this, and this is what I came up with. It's just a way to hold the part in the dividing head so I can mill two slots on opposite sides. I'm going to drill and tap a few holes now. The first two will be aligned with the slots I just made. They are for a couple of screws that will lock that ring in place. As for holding the center, I was thinking about having two set screws, but then I changed my mind. Having a third one, as close as possible to the work, should help with rigidity, so I'm adding one more. This decision actually compromised something else I had in mind, but we'll get there in a minute. So this hole doesn't go all the way through. Only the 3M6 for holding the center will. And after this, I can't forget to make another pass with the rimmer, just to clean up the hole. I was saying the other day I was reaching the working limits of my mill. I don't know, looks like it's getting shorter day after day. A 5C collet block would have been nice here, but I don't have one. So I'm replacing the dividing head with the rotary table. I'm sure it will... Oh, crap. Wait, I just remembered something. Baby chuck doo 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 doo, baby chuck doo 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 doo, baby chuck. Baby chuck doo 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 doo, baby chuck doo 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 doo, baby chuck. Baby chuck. I can't say if this was my father's or my grandfather's, but I've had these for so many years. I guess this is what you'd call new old stock. In a way, it kind of feels wrong to put it to use, but I'm sure they would approve. I'm not sure what to call this next part. Basically, it's the interface that will drive the stock. It's like a top cap that bolts onto the business end of the tool. And the cool thing is that it can be replaced. Today I might be driving squares, but tomorrow I can easily change to something else. This screw is from a set of door hinges I've been working on. Other than these, I only have longer screws, and I don't feel like cutting them now. And just like that, all the holes are done. Funny how every time I forget to press record, the work just gets done. I'm trying to get the square centered, but actually it doesn't matter. This will be a loose fit for the part anyway. If it were a tight fit, it would probably throw things out of alignment. I don't like to shorten countersunk screws, there's no easy way to hold them on the lathe to finish the end, not without making another tool anyway, and I don't feel like doing that right now. Instead, I'll spend the time making another driving plate. You know, for one of my lathe dogs. I won't show you every detail of this, because I forgot to press record, because this is a side project, and it's supposed to be a quick one. But I don't think I have shown this chuck before. It's the original chuck that came with my lathe. I wasn't using it, and I figured it was a good candidate for this modification. Actually, I saw this in one of Joe Pye's videos. Probably you have seen that one too. It's one of the most viewed. So, I modified this chuck because I needed a round parallel for my rotary table. But since then, I found myself using this a lot. Just to give you an idea, if you're careful and don't over-tighten the chuck jaws, this is what you can get. Note that I didn't take any time to align this disc. I just flipped it and faced the other side. Now, I need to find the correct location for the four mounting holes. I should have taken my references from the center of the sliding part when I first drilled and tapped the holes, but I didn't. So now, what I'm going to do is transfer the location of one hole to the disc, and then use the rotary table to make the other three holes, just like before. I tried to fix the disc again to get rid of some scratches, but I got some chatter. It's just too thin and the interruptions aren't helping. Anyway, I stopped before this is reduced to nothing. Turns out, I had these screws the entire time. These are the originals from the door hinges I just mentioned. And they are shallower too, which is perfect for this finishing pass. And finally, I'll mill a flat on this portion of 1045 steel. This will be the center for the tool. I was telling you, a minute ago, that having a third set screw for the center actually compromised something else I had in mind. Well, when I started with this, the idea was just having a spring pushing on some sort of adapter. But the idea evolved and I kept the spring. And any minute now, I'm about to realize how that won't work. Wait for it. Wait for it. There you go. Duh. And although that would have been awesome, I don't really need it. I wasn't expecting to make this tool or a specific video about it for that matter. It just happened while I was making something else and found myself with no way to drive that part between centers. And given the flexibility to change the adapter plates, I thought this was interesting enough to share with you. Maybe one day you might need something similar and remember this video. Sometimes it pays off to stop a project, to make something that will make your life easier many times in the future. And I'm sure you can pull off a tool like this in a fraction of the time, even if it doesn't shine this much. For now, the only thing left for me to do is apologize for the Baby Chuck song. It will probably wear off until tomorrow, don't worry.